I was witness, and I was saying, I do appreciate the dedication. It grieves me that they're doing this for the wrong cause and for a cult and for false teaching. It grieves me. I said, but, in point of fact, they are dedicated. He said, it's true, but there's tremendous legalistic push, and you have to do things, and there's pressure to put in your hours. In other words, it's not out of a love for God and a love for souls that many people are knocking on your doors. It's out of a legalistic requirement that they have to do it. And there's a vast difference. Yes, ultimately, we love Jesus so much. We love the Lord so much that we just have to tell everybody. We love the Lord so much that we just have to go to the ends of the earth. We love the Lord so much that we don't care what it costs us, what the sacrifice. Here I am. Send me. Use me. Absolutely. Along with that, though, there is a call to take up our cross, and that is a call that is sacrificial. That is a call to deny ourselves, and that is a call that is sacrificial. Conveniently, many hyper-grace teachers say, oh, no, that was spoken before the cross, and that only applied to the Jews. The most bogus, erroneous teaching circulating today that we absolutely demolish with Scripture in my book, Hyper-Grace. But in point of fact, the hyper-grace message, which wants people to feel secure and loved and all is right with you and God, which has a lot of truth to it. A lot of truth to it. Unfortunately, along with it, it absolutely undermines the call to sacrifice and service. So I began to, this is one thing that alerted me to hyper-grace a few years back when I post something on Facebook. Call us, run our race so as to win. 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24-27.
Monticello, Maine, USA.